Hello, I'm David Brown from the Solidworks training team. This video presents a project that you can use to hone your Solidworks skills and is easy to make if you have a basic 3D printer. When you first set up a new 3D printer, it is a good idea to run some test prints. This project is one that you can design in Solidworks, print yourself, and is useful for checking the accuracy of your 3D printer in the X, Y, and Z axes. The key aspects of this design that I will focus on are features, save to STL files, and 3D printing. Let's get started. You'll notice right away that the reference triad shows a Z-up orientation. I decided to change to this because my 3D printer bed is the same, and it makes this explanation clearer. To change to a Z-up orientation in SolidWorks, I press the spacebar to open the orientation dialog and select Apply Z-up Views from the dropdown. I start with a 1-inch center rectangle on the front plane, extruded 1-inch with a mid-plane extrusion. Remember, the front plane is the XY plane, and with the Z-up orientation, makes it appear to be the top plane. Of course, you can always rename the planes if you want. Next, I place a sketch with text representing the axes on three faces for X, Y, and Z. The reason I created the cube with a center rectangle extruded with a mid-plane extrusion is that it conveniently puts the origin at the center along with all of the planes naturally. At the intersection of the appropriate planes, I insert two reference axes to use for circular patterns. Axis 1 is created with the top and front plane. Axis 2 is created with the top and right plane. Lastly, I create a circular pattern using the axis for Z, and another one for X and Y. In addition to the 1-inch cube, I also made a 20mm cube using this same process. Once the cube is done, I need to save it as a file my 3D printer can understand, an STL file. I'll select Save As, Browse, Save as Type, and choose STL from the list, and then click Save. No matter how you create the cube, the key thing to remember for this project is to orient the cube properly on the bed of the 3D printer. Make sure the letters on the cube match that of the triad of the 3D printer slicer software. For most of the things I print, I use 0.15 millimeter and 0.2 millimeter layer heights. So I printed two versions of each cube to test these layer heights. I use black for 0.2 millimeter and white for 0.15 millimeter. This little cube is a great way to test the accuracy of your 3D printer. It helps me to choose the clearance values between parts with confidence as I'm designing. If I found one of the dimensions to be way off, then I would take steps with my 3D printer to recalibrate or make adjustments in the slicer software as necessary. As it is, my printer has performed very well right out of the box. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to this channel for upcoming projects in the Useful SolidWorks Design Projects You Can Make playlist, and if you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access more content for designing with SolidWorks.